morning, good afternoon, good night, wherever you're watching this from. Welcome to Assem Live. This is Assem Sports. Happy Monday, bright, beautiful, sunshine Monday, coming off an action-packed weekend. What a game. What a spectacular performance. The Premier League, the upper echelon, the creme de la creme. If there was ever one game to use as an advertisement, to use as a slideshow reel, to show how real and how spectacular the Premier League is, this weekend delivered nothing but bangers. Thank you for tuning in to Assem Sports. We're talking Premier League, the upper echelon, where the game between the Blues, the London Blue and the Manchester Blue, Chelsea and Manchester City, put up a spectacular performance that had people raving across social media and across the sporting world. Thank you for tuning in to Assem Sports. 4-4 was the final score. And Mauricio Pochettino, finally, his era looks like it has begun. Thank you for tuning in to Assem Sports. A lot of games went on in the Premier League over the weekend, going into the international break. But the Chelsea-Man City game took center stage. 4-4 at the Stamford Bridge. And as a Chelsea fan, I did state before the game that we should not go into the game with a mentality of getting a draw. And what I meant by that was sitting back and hoping to catch them on a counter, hoping to get lucky. Chelsea were brave for the first time in a long time. I saw my Chelsea blue. I saw the identity of what makes up this Chelsea fortitude squad. And I mean, Am I jubilating and celebrating? No. Chelsea could have won that game at home, and the goal that they conceded, the goals they conceded. I was never in doubt because we always created chances. Man City went ahead with an error by Cucurella. I mean, why do you stretch your hands and pull on somebody's shirt in the penalty box? In this day, in this modern game, at that level, like, who does that? So then you give them an easy way in. That penalty, Erling Haaland, it was a gift. And so, in as much as Chelsea won 4-4, I don't come from the era where you celebrate a draw. I don't care if it's Man City or Real Madrid. At Stamford Bridge, we should put our stance on any team that come there. And when we went down and Thiago Silva gave us an equalizer. I mean, Thiago Silva. Look, I mean, it was quite unfortunate that a deflection, just the irony and the poetry in football, that it was a deflection from Thiago Silva that gave Rodri the goal. But I'm just saying, Thiago Silva's had the goal. Then Chelsea went ahead 2-1 from Raheem Sterling. I mean, I must say, Raheem Sterling's performance against Man City. Cole Palmer. I mean, everybody played quite really well. I mean, regardless of how we defended, Reece James, it was quite a stellar performance, but Chelsea could have won that game when we went 2-1 up. And the goal that Akanji got to equalize. I mean, what terrible defending is that? At this level. And I'm saying all this to say, this was still the best performance we've seen Chelsea as yet. But that is not the stretch of where we can go. Thank you for tuning in to Assem Sports. Chelsea played 4-4. Going into the international break, Mauricio Pochettino obviously was fumed. He will be disappointed. And that is the spirit that I want to see in a manager. Mauricio Pochettino, I think he has finally gotten the fans on his side. This game could have been way better. Chelsea could have gotten the third goal through Cole Palmer. I mean, we created chances. Man City made some mistakes in their back with Guardiola, and they have some injuries, Nathan Ake and the rest. But, I mean, all in all, it was a great game. Liverpool also beat Brentford 3-0 going into the international break. But the Chelsea game was what became the topic of conversation. Thiago Silva getting a goal at 39 years. The level at which he plays and what he's able to do at his age. Some of these young chaps should take inspiration from that and go an extra step to help Thiago Silva. Thiago Silva should not be the one who is blocking a ball from Rodri at that distance, at that point in time of the game. Thiago Silva. But Thiago Silva at 39 was still forced to be the hero. And so, yes, Chelsea won 4-4. But as a Chelsea fan, we still have some cracks in this thing. Let's not get carried away. We don't celebrate a draw, even though it's a right score going to the international break. West Ham was also able to beat Nottingham Forest 3-2. Aston Villa still in flying form, beating Fulham 3-1. Brighton played 1-1 with Sheffield. Manchester United got a narrow. That seems to be their strategy. Pray and hope. Hope and pray for a miracle is what Manchester United is playing on against Luton Town at Old Trafford. Lindelof, the most unusual of suspects, is who got the goal for Manchester United. 1-0. Wolves in a very entertaining game, going to the dying minutes. When the game was almost over, 6 minutes to go, Tottenham Hotspur were leading Wolves 1-0, but the beautiful game of football, and it's undefiant, unforeseen circumstances. It's an adventure roller coaster. The Wolves came back at the 86th minute and got two goals, beating Tottenham Hotspur 2-1, and Postecoglou ball taking a hit. Arsenal still in doom, flying form, doing what they do best. They beat Burnley 3-1, and Bournemouth surprisingly at home beating Newcastle 2-0. So these were the games that went on in the Premier League over the weekend. Thank you for tuning in to Assem Sports. The Premier League and all other leagues around the world are going on international breaks. We're going to give you the rundown of all the games that are about to go down in the Euro qualifiers and friendly games. As we speak, the under-17 football soccer World Cup is also going on. In case you didn't know, we will give you information as they reach our desk. Like you already know, the Forecast 1.0, new Assem Music Collection, available on all platforms. Click the link in the bio. This has been Assem Sports. Have a wonderful week. What else are not coming soon? Over and out.